Hello friends, so now today welcome again, and it's today we have a topic of related to IPR, intellectual property rights. We will be covering branding, brand names, trademarks, copyrights, these kind of stuff we will be taking together. And today we have a battery of professionals speaking about the subject experts on this matter. To start with, Sujata Chaudhary. She's a lawyer. She's having experience of around 25 years. Not only India, ये international भी काफी काम कर चुकी हैं. 10 साल इन्होंने US के बहुत leading IP firms में काम किया है और अभी पीछे 8 साल से ये अपनी प्रैक्टिस IP attorney की तरह कर रहे हैं. और इन durations में ये काफी सारी संस्थाओं से जुड़ी हुई हैं. अभी ये जिंदल लॉ स्कूल में भी regular visiting faculties हैं, lectures वगैरह के लिए जाती रहती हैं. Second we have on dais Mr. Rajiv. And he is CA by profession, and then working on this field from last so many years. Currently, he is associated with Dubai-based incubator, Fastest Capital. He is actually a money man who gives on the funding side of business relate and these matters. And then we have Rahul Beror. Again, he is an IP professional, seasoned professionals guy is on working on the copyright matters. He is attached to so many of international organizations, say for example International Trademark Association and everything, and he is also representing their clients before Indian and international courts. So without taking much of time, I am handing over to Sujata to take through us on these brand and related ideas issues. Sujata,
thank you so much Nitin, thank you for the introduction, and thank you for having me on this session. So I am going to talk about trademarks and brand names today, and going to tell you what is the importance of protection of a trademark, how can you register a trademark, and what types of issues one might face in getting a trademark protected slash registered. So first of all, what is a trademark? It's a source identifier. We all know that. And trademarks can be of different types. They can be words, devices, numbers, letters, color combinations, packaging, and also sounds and shapes. Sounds and shapes are non-traditional trademarks. Why protect a trademark or a brand name? A very important reason for a startup is that a trademark or a brand name is an intangible asset. And what that means is, suppose aapne aaj startup set up kari hai, kal aap bechna chahte ho, the trademark can also be valued, and it is like any other asset. It is an intangible asset, so it has a value to it. And actually, trademark valuation is a very big business all around the world. Trademark is an indicator of quality. Jab koi trademark aapka dekhta hai, they immediately know ke wo good or service kahan se aa raha hai. So they know the source, they know ke ye quality achhi hogi, to humko ye good or service khareedni chahiye. Trademark is also an advertisement tool. Hum sab advertisement dekhte hain television mein, magazines mein, online, and we recognize a particular good and service by the trademark. So it is a advertising tool, very important advertising tool. Then another important reason to protect a trademark is that it gives you exclusive rights in that trademark. Aap agar protect karoge, then if you have good rights and you have protected rights, then you get exclusivity in the trademark. Aur koi nahi use kar sakta. Matlab karenge, but you will have recourse in courts of law agar koi karega, and you can also enforce your rights, like I said, because of the exclusivity. Now just to give you a little bit of an introduction on what is a good trademark and what is a bad trademark, there are two things when you select a trademark you should keep in mind. One, your trademark must not be descriptive. इसका मतलब क्या होता है? इसका मतलब होता है कि जब आप ट्रेडमार्क सिलेक्ट करते हो, वो ट्रेडमार्क ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए वो कि वो एकदम से आपके गुड्स और सर्विसेज को डिस्क्राइब करते। अब मार्केटिंग टेक्निक से अगर आप देखें तो हमेशा डिस्क्रिप्टिव ट्रेडमार्क अच्छा होता है, बिकॉज वो कंज्यूमर को बताता है कि आपके गुड्स और सर्विसेज क्या हैं। बट लॉ में अगर आप देखें तो ट्रेडमार्क डिस्क्रिप्टिव नहीं होना चाहिए। और क्यों नहीं होना चाहिए? बिकॉज वो इजिली प्रोटेक्टेबल नहीं हो सकता। आपके राइट्स वीक हो सकते हैं, आपके राइट्स एक्सक्लूसिव नहीं होंगे, क्योंकि और भी लोग वही ट्रेडमार्क यूज कर सकते हैं। सो एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ अ डिस्क्रिप्टिव ट्रेडमार्क आर इजी डाइनर। अब अगर आप इजी डाइनर देखो, आपको एकदम से पता चल जाएगा कि ये या तो रेस्टोरेंट्स के लिए है या खाने पीने के लिए है। सो ट्रेडमार्क लॉ के अंदर दिस इज नॉट अ गुड ट्रेडमार्क ऑन इट्स ओन, जस्ट द वर्ड इजी डाइनर, because it tells a consumer very easily what the goods and services are. shaadi.com ekdam se aapko pata chal jata hai ye koi website hai jo jo shaadi ke bare mein hogi. then non descriptive trademarks are nika. aap nika ko dekhenge aapko pata nahi chalega ki ye kya hai. that is a good trademark, it is a protectable trademark, it is a distinctive trademark, it's not a descriptive trademark. swiggy, aap swiggy dekhte hain abhi to aapko pata hai swiggy kya hai because it's well known, but agar aap waise swiggy dekhen you will not know ki ye food delivery service ka trademark hai. to ye strong trademarks hain, ye not descriptive hain aur ye acche trademarks mane jate hain. then the next thing that we have to keep in mind while selecting a trademark is it should not be similar to an existing or a prior trademark. ab ye maine yahan teen examples diye hain jo similar marks nahi mane gaye hain. smirnoff versus brisnoff, officer's choice versus forgy, and glucovita bolts versus glucon d bolt. ye cases ke upar banaye hain hum logon ne. And these were decided cases jisme court ne hold kara that these trademarks are not deceptively similar to each other. now let us take a look at what marks might be deceptively similar. to ab aap dekhiye ye Hyderabad Comic Con versus Kolhapur Comic Con. Delhi High Court held that they both are similar, they both were being used in connection with identical services and the marks were also very similar. BMW versus DMW again held to be deceptively similar. the DMW was not a good mark to choose because it is similar to BMW. American Eagle Outfitters versus Urban Eagle Authentic Outfitters, this was also held to be similar by the Delhi High Court. I should add that in Comic Con and American Eagle Outfitters the goods were also the same. both parties were selling clothing under American Eagle and Urban Eagle, and both parties were doing events under Comic Con. BMW mein, BMW to aap sabko pata hai kya hai, luxury automobile. jo DMW mark tha wo e-rickshaws mein use ho raha tha, but court ne kaha ki wo problem hai, DMW nahi use kar sakti hai party. Mercedes-Benz versus Benz underwear. Mercedes-Benz, we all know, luxury automobiles. Benz underwear, it was again, Benz underwear was held to be similar to Mercedes-Benz. So the gist of these slides is that when you choose a trademark, please give some thought to what trademark you're choosing. आप वैसा trademark select कीजिए जो दूसरे trademark से similar नहीं है और जो डिस्क्रिप्टिव नहीं है. डिस्क्रिप्टिव क्यों नहीं हम सिलेक्ट करेंगे? बिकॉज डिस्क्रिप्टिव मार्क्स जो होते हैं वो स्ट्रॉन्ग मार्क्स होते हैं, उनकी इन्फोर्समेंट में आपको प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है. देन लेट अस मूव ऑन टू रजिस्ट्रेशन. तो रजिस्ट्रेशन का प्रोसीजर बताने से पहले आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू जस्ट थ्री और फोर स्मॉल थिंग्स. इंडिया में देयर आर 5 ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रीज. Head registry is in Mumbai, and there are registries in Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, and Ahmedabad. So, agar aap file karte hain, jahan aap रेजिडेंट हैं, जहां आपका डोमिसाइल है, आपको उस रजिस्ट्री में एप्लीकेशन फाइल करनी पड़ेगी. देयर इज अ रिड्यूस्ड फाइलिंग फी फॉर स्टार्टअप्स एंड एमएसएमईज. ये अभी 2017 से शुरू हुआ है न्यू ट्रेडमार्क रूल्स में. ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्री डिस्काउंटेड फी देती है स्टार्टअप्स के लिए. अगर आपको डिटेल्स चाहिए, आई विल बी हैप्पी टू गिव द डिटेल्स आफ्टर द सेशन. देन इट इज एक्चुअली वेरी इजी टू फाइल अ ट्रेडमार्क एप्लीकेशन बिकॉज दिस कैन बी डन ऑनलाइन थ्रू द ई फाइलिंग पोर्टल ऑफ द ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्री. तो आपको फॉर्म भरना पड़ेगा, आपको डॉक्यूमेंट्स अपलोड करने पड़ेंगे एंड आप बस क्लिक कीजिए और आपकी एप्लीकेशन फाइल हो जाएगी, आपके पास फाइलिंग रिसीट आ जाएगी. और सर्चेस करना एक्सक्यूज मी बहुत जरूरी है. सर्चेस अभी मैं थोड़ी देर में भी कवर करूंगी बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस में. ये प्रोसीजर है ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रेशन का. सबसे पहले आप ट्रेडमार्क सर्च करिए. ट्रेडमार्क सर्च आप क्यों करेंगे? क्योंकि आपको देखना है कि कहीं आपने जो मार्क सिलेक्ट करा है वो ऐसा तो नहीं है जो सिमिलर है प्रायर मार्क से. किसी ने पहले ही एप्लीकेशन डाली हुई हो, किसी ने पहले ही रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑब्टेन करी हो सिमिलर मार्क के लिए, तो वो उसका आपको ध्यान रखना है. एंड यू मस्ट डू अ ट्रेडमार्क सर्च. ट्रेडमार्क सर्च कैन बी डन ऑन द ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रीज वेबसाइट. वहां पे सारे डिटेल्स होते हैं प्रायर रजिस्टर्ड और अप्लाइड फॉर मार्क्स के लिए. पर सर्च रिजल्ट को इंटरप्रेट करने के लिए इट इज बेटर इफ यू सीक लीगल हेल्प, बिकॉज थोड़ा मुश्किल प्रोसेस है वो इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द रिजल्ट्स. एक बार आपने ट्रेडमार्क सर्च कर ली एंड आपके रिजल्ट्स क्लियर हैं, आप फिर एप्लीकेशन फाइल करेंगे. एप्लीकेशन गेट्स एग्जामिन्ड बाय द ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्री एंड देयर माइट और माइट नॉट बी एन ऑब्जेक्शन. इफ there is an objection, then you respond to the objection. If there is no objection, that means your trademark application is accepted for publication. The next step is publication. What is publication? Har hafte trademark registry ek journal nikalti hai jisme sare jo accepted marks hain wo publish hote hain aur third parties ko chance diya jata hai ke wo इन मार्क्स के अगेंस्ट ऑब्जेक्शन फाइल कर सकते हैं. दैट मीन्स इट इज अ जर्नल दैट इज ओपन टू द पब्लिक. कोई भी कहीं भी अगर कहीं भी बैठा हुआ है किसी भी दुनिया के कोने में, दे कैन फाइल एन ऑपोजिशन और एन ऑब्जेक्शन टू द ट्रेडमार्क एप्लीकेशन. फिर अगर ऑपोजिशन नहीं होती है, पब्लिकेशन के करीब 6-7 महीने बाद ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रेशन इशू हो जाती है. और अगर ऑपोजिशन होती है फिर वो कंटेस्टेड मैटर होती है. इट इज लाइक अ मिनी लिटिगेशन. और अगर ऑपोजिशन क्लियर हो जाए फिर आपको रजिस्ट्रेशन मिल सकती है. ये सारा प्रोसेस अगर ऑपोजिशन नहीं हो करीब 7 महीने से 1.5 साल में कंप्लीट हो जाता है, आपको रजिस्ट्रेशन मिल सकती है. अब जनरल इश्यूज क्या आते हैं? एक तो फेलियर टू सर्च, ये मैंने ऑलरेडी डिस्कस करा है. बट व्हाई इज इट सो इम्पोर्टेंट टू सर्च? एंड आई विल रिपीट इट अगेन, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू सर्च बिकॉज यू डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू फाइल एन एप्लीकेशन, स्टार्ट यूजिंग अ मार्क ओनली टू डिस्कवर के आपके जैसे मार्क के लिए किसी ने ऑलरेडी पहले एप्लीकेशन फाइल कर दी है या किसी की रजिस्ट्रेशन है. Then what mark to file for? अब आप जब मार्क बनाते हैं या मार्केटिंग टीम जब मार्क बनाती है, वो 3-4 तरह के मार्क्स बनाती है, थोड़े थोड़े वेरिएशंस होते हैं. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू डिसाइड एक्यूरेटली, होपफुली विद अ लॉयर्स कंसल्टेशन, वॉट मार्क टू फाइल फॉर. वॉट मार्क विल गिव यू द बेस्ट प्रोटेक्शन दैट यू आर लुकिंग फॉर. नाउ एवरी ट्रेडमार्क इज connected to a good or service. हर company कोई good sell करती है या service offer करती है और उसके लिए वो trademark या brand name use करती है. These goods and services are classified in 45 classes that is used by the trademark office. So you have to be very, very careful that aapka jo good and service hai, that is classified in the correct class. Because agar aap incorrect class mein classify kar dete hain, then you cannot get protection for your goods and services. Then identity of the applicant. Kiske naam mein aap file karenge? Apne naam mein file karenge ya aapne company banai hai ya partnership firm hai ya LLP hai, aap kiske naam mein file karenge? It is very important to know that the application must be filed in the correct name. If it is not filed in the correct name, then that application may be void. So identity of the applicant is very important. Every application must state whether the mark is in use in India or will be used in India in the future. So you have to state the basis of use. Agar aap use basis pe file kar rahe hain, to aapko date of first use bhi deni padegi aur wo accurate honi chahiye. Nahi to again, that can be a cause for a third party to challenge your application. And you have to also submit evidence of use. Navigating the registry. अब जो हमारी ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रीज हैं वो अपने ही तरीके से ऑपरेट करती हैं. सो प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट यू आर फेमिलियर विद हाउ दे ऑपरेट, क्या प्रोसीजर्स हैं उनके. अगर आपको जाके किसी ऑफिसर से मिलना है कुछ डिस्कस करने के लिए, यू नो किसको मिलना है, कहाँ पे जाना है. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ आपने मार्क रजिस्टर कर लिया बट आपने यूज नहीं करा. लेट अस से आपने सेम मार्क के वेरिएशंस के लिए तीन या चार एप्लीकेशंस डाल दी अलग अलग वेरिएशंस के लिए, पर आपने सिर्फ एक ही यूज करा है. योर मार्क माइट, योर रजिस्ट्रेशन माइट बी ओपन टू कैंसिलेशन ऑन द ग्राउंड ऑफ नॉन यूज आफ्टर अ सर्टन टाइम पीरियड दैट इज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड अंडर द लॉ. So you have to be very careful that अगर आप application file कर रहे हैं, अगर आपको registration चाहिए, आप वो mark use करेंगे. नहीं तो थोड़े समय बाद that registration may be challenged for non-use. Applications, registrations for similar marks, ये अभी मैंने search में cover कर दिया था कि you have to be careful that your marks are, your chosen marks or your applied for marks are not similar to prior marks that are used by parties. Then agar aapki license agreements hain ya aapki jo IP hai, trademarks hain, wo assign hue hain, please be sure to make to that the agreements are very watertight, they have good language, they have been drafted or looked at by a lawyer. It is very important. And the next issue is lack of marketplace enforcement. आपने registration तो ले ली और आपको पता है कि कोई दूसरी पार्टी आपके जैसा mark use कर रही है और आपने कुछ नहीं करा उसके बारे में. That is a dangerous thing to do. Yes, we do realize that enforcement can be expensive, but it is money well spent because you want to keep up your position in the market. So please enforce where it is necessary. So just in the end, some suggested best practices: seek legal advice when you're filing, when you're enforcing, conduct trademark searches. As I said, these can be done very easily on the registry's website, but interpretation is quite an art, so please seek legal advice for that. File for the correct mark, like we discussed. Black and white or color, aap color of course use karenge, but aapko color mein file karna chahiye? Probably nahi, because black and white se aapko sabse broad protection milti hai. Correct class mein file kariye aur broadly file kariye. Goods and services should be described broadly. Documents rakhiye about use etc. so that agar registry mangti hai, agar aapko enforcement karna hai aur documents submit karne hai, those documents are ready. Take appropriate and timely action against any infringers etc. This is very important. Like I said, कि कोई दूसरी पार्टी है वो अपने rights build करती जा रही है, आपने कुछ नहीं करा, that is to your detriment. It might be very, very harmful to your business in the future. Thank you.
समझाया ब्रांड नेम क्या है क्यों चाहिए और कैसे अप्लाई करना और कैसे ध्यान रखना है. थैंक्स फॉर योर इनसाइट. नाउ आई विल बी हैंडिंग इट ओवर टू राजीव फॉर टेकिंग इट अप फर्दर. राजीव.
थैंक यू नितिन, थैंक यू फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी ऑन द लाइव शो एंड टेकिंग योर फर्स्ट पॉइंट इनटू कंसिडरेशन that I am a money man. Well, that money actually flows from the right protection that you take for your brand. So as Sujata has very nicely articulated the nuances of applying for a trademark and the mistakes little bit which we all make, you know, that makes a lot of difference into what is the value that you create for your brand to encash it later, as she very well said, that, you know, probably you want to sell your company off, you can hive off your company. If you want to hive off your brand, then you can hive off your brand. So you have a double value attached to it. As for the Madrid filing, so taking it further from the detailed methodology and the details which a trademark should be looked into, as narrated by Sujata, Madrid is basically a single filing platform for all those countries who are part of the protocol. So what happened was that companies were facing problems, you know, one filing to be done in India, then you make a subsidiary in Singapore, so you apply a trademark in Singapore, then so on and so forth, every country, every lawyer, every fees, etc., etc., you know, so multiple people to be coordinated with, looked into, money factor, fee factor, and other language issues and so many other things. So there was this protocol came into being, which is we all know as the Madrid protocol. So wherein there are regulations, there are administrative instructions, there are laws which are national, which are harmonized to the protocol, so that all the countries agree to having a mark which is based out of the origin country, say in India, across the 122 odd countries which are part of the protocol. So then you have the protection options. The first protection option is your own homeland, where you are having a company or a business or area of operation, say in India. So you can always file one application in India, for India, under the various classes, design or trade or name, black and white, color, whatever. Then you have the regional option as well. Now, what has happened is that over the years, few countries have realized their power of regionalism, as the EU, as Africa, which is the ARIPO, then the Benelux countries, and then the OAPI, which is part of some part of Africa, which is not part of the ARIPO. Then you go to the Madrid protocol, which is the international protocol. So a company has the option either to go the national route or take a selective regional route or take the international route. So as I said, that the nuances of going singular into a single country creates its own sets of problem by you know, having a battery of lawyers and applications and fees and other things. So therein the plus that happens is the Madrid system of filing. It's an international filing, which is done by way of a centralized single form check the box methodology. You select the country which you would like to be doing your business in. There will be a fees populated for that. Then there will be a mark which you will categorize, the class that you will define, and so on and so forth. The application shall be prepared. Now, the difference between a single application or a regional application vis-a-vis the Madrid application is that there is a single application filing with a single set of fee. Only the fees that is differing is the regional country-wise fee which is determined for the filing. Rest is all to be controlled from your origin state, which is India. So you have a lawyer in India. He files a Madrid application. You pay the fees for the regional parts. Done with. So then whatever regional queries that come back, those have to be addressed, which may be in terms of some objection related to the mark or for some other reason or the class. And then you can suitably reply and get over with it, and the application can move on to the next level. So basically, Madrid is a very broad coveraged protocol. So as of now, you have 113 countries covered, by which about 97 are members of the system, and some other regional countries and associations which have joined the protocol. So as said again, it's a single filing. So out of those 97 members, if you are walking into, say, 12 members, that single application will be filed with all those 12 members with a check the box option, fees paid, and application filed. These is the 97 countries, including the EU and the OAPI, which are marked in red, which are part of the protocol. So sitting out of India, you can go out and, you know, file an application across all these countries, and vice versa. If you're, say, your home base is America and you have a subsidiary in India, then you can base your application out of America to India. These are the benefits of the local business and the industries. So basically what happens is this trademark protection is important for the home market. Home market means the one where you're doing business. So if you're entering into a country A, then they have their own regulations. Okay, boss, you cannot sell your products here till the time we show you a trademark of the same product in the country of doing business. So therein it helps you to be a part of that country, doing that business, you know, and applying for that trademark. Then there are various routes to protecting your mark. Madrid is one of the regional, or rather international, facility which is granted. Then you have the regional and your local filings which are there. The best part of the entire filing is that it's a centralized management of the entire trademark that you have. So a single trademark, single application moved out to all those countries under a single umbrella, under a single authority, finished. Your job is done. Your mark is protected. Now we come to the features of Madrid filing. See, the basic features, nuances are exactly on the similar lines as what Sujata has said, which you do for your local filing, say in India. The same methodology, search, duplicacy, black and white versus color, trademark design, search, all those things matter here as well. So before getting into that particular territory, it would be advisable that you do a small search for that mark and that class in that country to get over with that initial teething troubles. As for the timeline, again, it's an international application, so more or less works on the local regional timeline, which is, you know, similar to 12 to 18 months from the day you file your application and you get a protected mark application accepted. Then you go down to the IPR rights. IPR is basically your intangible, as she very well said, which sits outside your books, gives you a value, which you can then cash, maybe later on down the line. All depends on how you get it registered, whether in your individual name, into a maybe a holding company, maybe your operating company. Company can be in any form. It can be an LLP or a company or a partnership. It depends. Then you have the feature of tailoring your trademark country by country. So it's not necessary that the same class that you file in India, you need to file the same class everywhere else. Country by country, you can make a little bit of difference to file class by class. And of course, the best part is that you have a centralized management, single application, single person. So you know where the things are moving, which country has accepted it, which has raised a mark for it or an objection for it, and so on and so forth. So the basic and the best part about Madrid is that it's a single platform wherein all your trademark related marks, nuances, issues, classes are all taken care of. So this ends my small chat on Madrid filing, which is basically a single platform, as I said, and I repeat again. And the best part is that you deal with just one attorney, maybe sitting out of India, and doing all your compliances across the globe.
Thanks, Rajiv ji. आपने बताया कैसे हमारे brand को हम internationally भी protect कर सकते हैं. And it's always good when you grow business बढ़ जाता है तो international brand की जरूरत पड़ती है. Now I would like to hand over to Rahul Bairor ji. Who can just talk about the copyrighted items, how to get it copyright, importance or those sab cheeje. So please welcome Rahul ji, handing over to you.
Thank you, Nitin. Thank you, Rajiv. And thank you, Sujata, for leading it and giving a nice explanation how to go about the trademark and the Madrid protocol. Now, today I will be talking about the copyright. So what is the copyright? Why do you need to protect copyright? What are the benefits of protecting copyright? So I will not be doing any presentation here. I will just taking extempore. So the first thing that copyright is, in my understanding, copyright is the law of copyright is right to copy. So now you have a right to copy something, but is it free for everyone to copy? No. You have to take the permission of the person who has created the original work. So copyright vests in so many things like artistic work. You create something like musical work, and then you have artistic work, then you have literary work where if you write a novel, then it's protected. So why the legislature has given an exclusive protection? Copyright is also exclusive protection. So once you create a work, normal circumstances, it will be 60 years plus life of the author. So suppose a person A has created a work, literary work or a novel, say a novel. So the copyright in the work will be protected through his life plus 60 years. So when we talk about copyright, copyright is part of the IPR. IPR is intellectual property. So intellectual property is something that you create, is an intangible asset. You create from your creativity, you use your mind to create something. And it has same value when it goes to, when you monetize it. So once you have created a work, you publish the work, you issue the copies to the public, and then the public buys that work and gives you right in form of royalty otherwise. So most of the questions that it comes to us is that if something is available on the internet and I want to use it and it's available, there's no restriction, I can copy it. So most of the time, what we have seen is that people copy it from internet, not knowing that while copying or taking that thing out from the internet, you're actually infringing the copyright of the person who originally was the creator and who may have the licensed version of that work. So once you have copied something and then put on a viewer website, then the person who has actually created it will either sooner or later come to know that you have copied it without his permission. And then he issue a legal notice to you. Then you have to defend that why and how you have copied it, whether that work that you have copied was under copyright. And if you copied it, what is the recourse that you can take? So copyright actually protects the basic expression that you have. The work that is originally created by you is protected under copyright. It's not that anything and everything that you create will be protected under copyright. So recently, the Supreme Court of India has done away with the procedure where everything was protected in copyright, irrespective of whether it is something creativity or not. So now if I write my name, it's not protected in copyright. Because it has to be some creativity of modicum. There has to be some modicum of creativity that the person who has created that work has actually done some creative work. It's not that everything has copyright. But if it comes to photograph, which falls into artistic work, there's a copyright the moment you click a photograph. Now the question normally arises that who has the copyright in the photograph that you have taken? Suppose you have taken a photograph of a celebrity. So the celebrity will have a right or you will have a right. Under law, the person who's taking the photograph will have all the right. And the copyright is a set of rights. It's not one right. So copyright includes the right to issue copies, the right to reproduce the work, the right to monetize and license the work, and many other things. So now, why you need to protect copyright? So the protection is required because if you don't protect it, then everyone is going to misuse your work and take benefit, gain benefit from them without compensating you. So copyright recognizes two, three things. That first, it recognizes the effort that you put to create the work. It encourages originality so that not everyone copies everything that's available out there. It monetizes your work. So if you have created some work and you want to license it, then you have option of putting a license fee to it. And then it safeguards the author's right. And it prevents other parties from unauthorized exploitation. So in copyright or in IPR general, you have to be very clear that everything, anything, if you want to license it, it has to be in writing. In IPR, nothing flows on verbal communication. So everything, anything that you want to give to someone, it has to be reduced in writing. The law recognizes that without an instrument in writing, there's no shift of copyright or trademark or for patent rights. It has to be, if you want to license someone, if you want to authorize someone to use it, it has to be reduced in writing. So basic is that once you've created something original, how do you inform the other party that this is your work? So mostly we have seen that we put a C in bracket and put a year that this work was created, say I created a work in 2020, I'll put copyright in a bracket, which is the symbol of saying that the work is under copyright, and then put year of creation. So if I say 2020, so it will be the life of the author. If you have created a photograph, then that's 60 years. That's the duration of copyright. So once this duration of copyright is over, then it becomes in a public domain. Then it goes to free domain. Anyone can copy it, anyone can use it. There's no royalty, there's no license, there's no permission granted. So suppose you have done all the precautions, taken all the precautions, and you've created work, someone, you find that someone is using it, and then how do you stop it? So if you have the notices, if you have the year of publication, and you have the all the manuscript, all the details to prove that yes, this was created by you, and you are the creator. So if in case of photograph, you should know which camera was used, who was the photographer, and when that photograph was created. So you, in that case, when you see someone that they have been using the photograph without your permission, you go to the court, tell the court that this is my original creation. It was, give the details of the creation. And if you have copyright certificate, which I talked about later, then the court will grant you injunction. Injunction is the procedure where the court on the first date of hearing, basically in original site practice, which is Delhi, Mumbai, and Calcutta, and Chennai. So it will grant you injunction. Injunction is the order of the court to the other party not to continue infringing your work. So it's like restraining order, that the other party is restrained from using your work, and they have to come to the court and give an explanation that why and what permission they had to use the work. So once the life of the author for 60 years, the tenure is over, there's no renewal. So once you have created work, the time comes to an end and it becomes free. So most of the time we also have a notice that, okay, fine, I've created work, but I've never published it. Publishers that you have now never brought that work to the general public. The work has not seen the light of the day. You created it, you write a novel, you've written a novel, you put it in the cupboard. So will the copyright vest in that? Yes. If you've written a novel which is original to you, it should not be copied or taken from someone's sources, or maybe compilation of like six stories which are all written by different authors and you compile it and with no input, then there's no copyright in that. So if you are writing your autobiography, if you're writing a story which is your expression, it should not be copied expression, then the copyright vests in it and then you will be granted protection. But most of the time what we advise is that once you've created an original work and you want to protect it, seek copyright registration. Copyright registration is not a expensive procedure to follow. It's very, I can say this, very least expensive of all copyright or all IPR protection. You make a form, file it before copyright registry, give the ownership details that you, when the work was created, give a manuscript for the work, and you're done with. So once they issue a copyright certificate, then you take to the court and court will look into the copyright certificate, and this is that you will have the injunction or the restraining order against the other party from copying it. Or maybe with the new High Court rules, there is whatever you have spent money in, say, bringing the other party to court, the court fees and every expenses has to be borne by the other party. So this is the nut and shell of copyright. So now there are many questions that we have. So I'm taking Anshul Kumar's question, where he has said that copyright registered like just like the trademark. Yes, copyright can be registered like the trademark, but the trademark is a continuous right. So once you have registered it, every 10 years you have to keep renewing it. But in copyright, once you have registered it, it is valid for the tenure, life of the author, plus 60 years. After that, it's free. Now, the next question that we have is that whether it applies to fitness industry. So fitness industry, so we have recently done a cases where people have shot videos of their gym exercising technique, where they have reduced weight, which was a weight loss process, and they have shot a video. There was a controversy. Who owns the right in the video? The person, which I've got earlier, the person who is featuring in the video, the premises on which the video was shot, or the person who's shooting the video. In copyright, if you are within premises, legally entered, there's no trespass. That suppose you are entering my premises and I have invited to be in my premises and you shoot something, then the copyright belongs to you. But if you have shot within my premises, without my consent, then I can file a criminal case against you, but the copyright is still vested with the person who has shot the video. So now the next question is that how does copyright work in a startup scenario? So whatever I'm going to tell you is about the basis our understanding and the experience that we have in the copyright, on basis the client that we have till date handled. So in startup scenario, what we all startup forget is that once you have a website, because nowadays everyone in social media, so many times it is outsourced to this vendor to create the website. There we don't have an agreement. There's no agreement between you and the vendor who created the website. The content that you put is also given mostly by the vendors. There's no agreement which says that whatever he's created belongs to you. You are the one who's paying it. But in the absence of, which I told you, in the absence of any written agreement, there's nothing that you can do because it belongs to him, though the website may be yours. And many times the vendor may be taking out things from internet, assuming that everything on the internet is free, which is not the case, and put it on your website. Then you have a notices from the person whose work was used to create your website without the permission. You have a notice coming from them, and then you have either two options. Either you accept the notice, the demands made in the notice, pay them whatever they want, and either change your website or close the website. So when it comes to startup, you have to be very careful that what is yours should only be out there. You should not be copy. And in case you want to inspired by someone, then inspire it should not be a mounting copy. Get inspired. There's a lot of ideas out there, but put your expression, put your words there, not someone else's word. So if you, now the next question is about blog. I'll come to the copyright software code later on, about the blog. So if you have, suppose you're writing a blog and you have quoted someone else, suppose you have quoted a author, then in that, but that quote is about a paragraph and the blog is all about how the author has done it, what's your take on the author, your impression about the author, your view about the author, and there you have quoted a one paragraph, which is word by word what the author has said. But if you have given the source, you have not hidden this source, that you have not projected that this is my work. You have said that author has said this and put it in quote. And in somewhere else, you can also attribute that this was taken from the author. Then there's no issues. As long as source is clear that this work was copied or taken, if you have permission, well and good. If you don't have permission and you have given attributes that this work or this is a quote from this book or this author, there's no issues. So which authority we need to register copyright? So there's a copyright board which registers, and it is based in Delhi. So it registers the original work. It registers also the software code if you want, because most of the website that we have is object and source code. It registers the layout of the your website also. So every layout, the pictures, the content on the website is protected under the layout, so which you can protect. So now coming to the next questions, that casino games. So casino games, algorithm till date is a gray area whether you can protect algorithm under patent law or not. There's no copyright for algorithm, which is a computer generated programs, but you may have a copyright if the code that you've written is yours, it's not copied from someone else. Copyright covers the entire India. And one thing about the copyright is that is once you've created work in India and it's original work, under Berne Convention, it's protected across the world as if it's the same thing. So if you have created work in India and someone starts copying it in USA and you come to know it and start putting it on their website, you can still issue notice to them and they will be obligated to remove it because the DMCA, which is the Digital Millennium Copyright Act of USA, allows you to ask them to pull out. The process for copyright registration takes about 10 to 15 months maximum if there's no objection from the trademark or from the copyright board. So now is the next question, is that on patent, on process of manufacturing any work. So patent, we are not dealing today, but I can just tell you that patent is provided when there's invention. So if you invented something, then you have a patent in that. So, but this is not today's presentation. We'll cover it later on. So that's all a short point on the copyright. If you have more questions, you can touch base with us.
Thanks, Rahul, for giving your presentations, your insight on this, and picking up the questions as well. Now, let me take other panelists also on the screen. We have one more stuff since this copyright is going on. Let me ask just if copyright, related to copyright only. One of the audience has asked that if we go for the copyright, the timing, as you said, it may take a year or 15 months. Any idea of the cost, like what's the major cost involving this kind of process?
I think the government fees is about 500 rupees, but the lawyers could be range about 7,000 to 8,000 rupees.
Okay.
Depending on the work. But every lawyer has a different take. So someone will say 7,000 to 8,000. The lawyer's fees is not standardized, but the government fees is 500 rupees.
Government fees is 500. That's great. One question this related to trademark. What we have seen the queries come that one is looking for a particular trademark which is already taken by someone but not using it as such. And now the question is ke wo use kar raha hai ya nahi kar raha hai wo hame kaise pata lag sakta hai ya yadi wo use nahi kar raha hai to hum uske liye kaise aage go forward kar sakte hain so that ki brand name mera stuck nahi ho main usko use kar paun. So Sujata ji aap kuch roshni mein.
So hamare area mein we use investigators. Investigators go out into the market and they will do an investigation and send a report to us on what the other party is doing. Basically, we provide them all the information. They go and they make discrete inquiries from the party involved. And if it turns out that a party is not using a trademark, have a registration here, so they have statutory rights and those rights are very strong. So tab aap strategy banani padegi, unka hum trademark cancel kar sakte hain kyunki unhone use nahi kara. Agar cancellation period mein nahi hai, then maybe you can approach them for a buyout. So there are various strategies that will have to be made depending on what the investigation report reveals. Or agar wo use kar rahe hain, then I think the investigator should be asked to investigate what is the type of use, is it very extensive, is he very invested in the mark, will maybe he is willing to sell the mark to you. Agar matlab jo startup hai usko bahut acha lag raha hai trademark and they say we want this trademark, then maybe they can buy out the other party, spend, you know, depending on the investment. Agar wo itna invested nahi hai dusri party, and if the trademark doesn't contribute a lot to the revenue of the other party, maybe they'll be willing to sell it. So strategies have to be made depending on what the investigation report reveals. But finding out what the use status, etc., is, it's a very easy thing to do, actually. We hire investigators routinely in our business, and they are very, very good at going and making discrete inquiries from these parties. Nitin,
am I audible? The question is that how to find out ki patent ya trademark copyright kiske naam se hai, so that say as you suggest ki ho sakta hai wo bechne ke liye bhi interested ho, to kaise pata kaise lagega ki kisne le rakha.
Wo to agar aap search karoge, agar applied for ya registered hai, wo to trademark registry ki website se pata chal jata hai. All the details of the applications are uploaded, applications and registrations. You can get to know from there. Agar registered hai, tab thoda, matlab you have to do Google searches and try to find out a telephone number or an email address or a physical address.
Okay.
So as far as the patent or copyright is concerned, patent can be freely searchable at the patent database provided by the trademark registry patent office. And for copyright, you have to see the work. So most of the work will have a copyright notice saying that this is the work, and copyright say copyright Albert or copyright Nitin Goel, and they will be year of one. Then you have to go back to the certain person and get the work.
That's great. Abhi kuch Sujata ji is here.
Elaborate on the consequences of non-registration of a trademark for an Indian startup. So may I answer that?
Yeah, please carry on.
So the registration is not mandatory, but it is recommended because it does give statutory rights. Aap infringement ka action file kar sakte hain. आपको एक्सक्लूसिव प्राइमर फेस एक्सक्लूसिविटी मिल सकती है अगर आप रजिस्टर करते हैं. यू कैन बिल्ड राइट्स इवन बाय मियरली यूजिंग अ मार्क इन इंडिया, बट इट इज बेटर टू हैव इट रजिस्टर्ड बिकॉज अ रजिस्ट्रेशन इज देयर ऑन द ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्टर. इट इज प्राइमर फेस एविडेंस ऑफ एक्सक्लूसिविटी. कोर्ट्स रिकॉग्नाइज दैट पीस ऑफ पेपर, द रजिस्ट्रेशन सर्टिफिकेट. सो इट इज ऑलवेज बेटर टू रजिस्टर.
ओके सुजाता जी, वन रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन. से दो लोग एक ही ट्रेडमार्क यूज कर रहे हैं और एक्चुअली रजिस्टर्ड नहीं है तो ट्रेडमार्क शायद नहीं बोलेंगे टेक्निकली. दो लोग एक ही मार्क यूज कर रहे हैं और किसी ने भी उसको रजिस्टर्ड नहीं कराया. इफ आउट ऑफ देम वन इज गोइंग फॉर गेटिंग दिस ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रेशन, तो बेनिफिट ऑफ डाउट या प्रिफरेंस किसको मिलेगा?
So, सबसे पहले नितिन, आई वुड से इवन इफ अ ट्रेडमार्क इज नॉट रजिस्टर्ड, इट इज अ ट्रेडमार्क. यू हैव राइट्स अगर आपने यूज करा है. यू डोंट हैव टू हैव अ रजिस्ट्रेशन. दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग. सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट इफ देर आर टू पार्टीज यूजिंग द सेम मार्क, यू हैव टू सी विच वन स्टार्टेड यूजिंग फर्स्ट. There is a concept of earlier trademark of priority in our jurisprudence. So you have to again investigate, see who started using first, and then determine the relative rights of the parties.
That's great. One more question that related to specifically for Madrid Protocol, that what is the cost around it? Rajiv, if you can have some idea.
Nitin, the cost around it is basically based upon country by country. So the number of countries that you want to do. So I guess the minimum is like about 10 odd thousand bucks per country kind of a cost.
Okay. And the benefit ultimately, which I understand from this Madrid, is that if you are getting taking help of this Madrid convention, aap Madrid convention ka help lete hain, to मेरा ब्रांड जो मैंने इंडिया में रजिस्टर्ड करा रखा है, मैं उसको ग्लोबली भी प्रोटेक्ट रख सकता हूं.
करेक्ट.
दैट्स ग्रेट. वन क्वेश्चन, दैट 10,000 इज रुपीस और डॉलर? राजीव,
वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन.
यस, फॉर द टाइम बीइंग लेट्स ट्रीट इट एज डॉलर.
Okay.
No. The cost is 17 times. Yeah, it's about the Indian rupees, not the dollar.
That's great. So, thanks to all of you guys taking out time and sharing your experience. और उन सबसे भी अच्छी बात, बहुत simple तरीके से बताया आपने और एकदम कैसे practically उसको handle करना है, क्यों चाहिए और कैसे चाहिए. Thanks for your time. And thanks for the audience to have asking for these queries and be interactive in that. In case you, any of guys has any other questions, they may reach us to any time on our to us, then we will be handling it. Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you.